Euzu billahi mineşşeytanirracim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Elhamdülillah. Elhamdülillahi'llezî hadana li hâzâ ve mâ kunnâ linehtediye levlâ en hadânallâh. Eşhedü en lâ ilâhe illallah vahdehu lâ şerîke leh ve eşhedü enne Muhammeden abduhu ve resûlüh. Ersele resûlehu bil hudâ ve dînil hak li yuzhirehu ale'd-dîni kulli ve lev kerihel müşrikûn. Ama بعد يقول تعالى في كتاب الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين صدق الله العظيم committed Muslims brothers sisters and children in Islam Alhamdulillah we arrive at Jum'atul Wida, the last Jum'ah in the glorious month of Ramadan. But regrettably, we cannot offer Jum'ah Salat in congregation because of the peculiar conditions that we are facing. But this does not mean that we abandon our ibadat. In fact, it should spur us more to increase our ibadat, and in particular, as these couple of ayats from Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ Allah says, if you remember me, I will remember you. وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ And express your gratitude to me and do not deny my power presence. And then Allah tells us, addressing us as Allazina amanu, O you who have made a firm commitment to Allah, seek constancy and comfort and solace in patience and in salat. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu sta'inu bis-sabri was-salat. Inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. Verily Allah is with those that show patience. So Allah is reminding us that whatever the circumstances, if we show patience, if we remember Allah, if we express our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then He would be with us. Now, how do we remember Allah is something that we need to pay attention to. Remembrance of Allah is, in fact, in abiding by the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remembrance is not merely verbalizing things, but acting upon them. Because in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Noble Quran, constantly reminds us whenever He says, Allazina amanu, in fact, often it is followed by wa'amilu salihat. Very often in the Quran, we find this expression. That means, O you who have made a commitment to Allah, that you have iman, that you have faith commitment, you should supplement it with righteous deeds. And what are righteous deeds? First and foremost, of course, we must never associate partners with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it absolutely clear in the Noble Quran that associating partners with Allah is the greatest of sins. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. That shirk is the greatest of injustices that any human being can commit. And this obviously particularly applies to the Muslims. And we can, in fact, commit shirk inadvertently without realizing it. So what we have to understand is that Allah is one. He is unique. He is the one who is transcendence. That's why whenever He is transcendent. And that's why in one of these very, very oft recited surahs of the Quran, Surah Ikhlas, when we remind ourselves, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ السَّمَدْ Allah says, say that Allah is the one who is absolutely one and unique. اللَّهُ السَّمَدْ That He is Samad, that He is the one who is absolutely transcendent, who is the one that has, He is unique, He has given us everything that we have in our lives. So it is important that we pay attention to this aspect of the oneness, transcendence and uniqueness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, our remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be manifested in our support and expression for needy and destitute people. There are many, many people that are suffering. We are, alhamdulillah, fortunate that we are well off, that we are, we don't face the kinds of dangers that the millions and millions of Muslim refugees face all over the world, and other poor people. There is mass poverty all around the world. And in this month of Ramadan that is coming to an end, and in particular Jumatul Wida, we should pay attention to the fact that all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us, that we should in fact share some of these bounties with those that are less fortunate than ourselves. It is in this way that we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would extend His mercy and grace to us. We hope and pray inshallah that your month of Ramadan has gone well, that you have been able to continue to observe your fasts and continue to study the Quran and understand it so that we can implement it in our lives. We pray to Allah to bless you, to accept your ibadat, and continue to offer His protection to you through all these troubled times. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.